Hello everybody, and welcome to Basement Electronics. So this video is actually the same video that I posted back on Sunday, except this one isn't reversed. I posted Sunday's video because I do enjoy making fun videos for the April Fool's days. Last year I did the video on sound with no sound. Year before that, I did a let's play the Chrome dinosaur running game. So I decided the backwards video would also be fun. But for most people who probably didn't make it all the way through the video, this is what we're doing today. We're going to be building the robot car kit. So this is just a kit I got off Amazon, and it was about $100 Canadian, but it looked really interesting. So this is based on an Arduino Uno, and then it has a number of peripherals attached to it, such as the sonar? Yeah, I think that's sonar. Object detector. It has the infrared remote control. It has Bluetooth for connecting to your phone, so you can control it with an app. Of course, controlling the servos for the wheels. And then it also has sensors on the bottom for... you can't see that. So it also has sensors on the bottom here for following lines. So just the number of things you can do with this is really interesting, and I thought it'd be a really good project to do. So in this video, we're going to start with just the building it, and then the future videos, we're going to start with the programming and taking a look at the actual functionality. So let's get building. So here's the kit. Here's the box it comes in. It's actually a really nice box. Decent quality plastic. Inside, kind of see a list of all the parts. CD with the instructions, and I've already kind of looked at it, and I have a copy of the PDF already up on the computer screen that I'm going to be following with. Then a little thank you card. Let's get my hand out of the way and get the glare. So we got our battery box. I'm just debating whether or not to try to lay this stuff out. It does come with tools. Okay, that makes that easier. So actually comes with the screwdriver and then a hex driver. I was kind of worried. I actually had to, get my hex keys and my small screwdrivers out just in case. So here's our battery charger, which, you know what, before I get started, I'm going to put the batteries on the charge. Like that. Then lithium ion 3.7 volt batteries. 8.14 watt hours, so nice beefy batteries. Of course, being lithium ion, be really careful taking out of this shrink wrap plastic, because you do not want to nick them. Well, the first step we're going to need to the motors. Let's get it back here so I have nice workspace. I need two of the motors. I really like how this stuff's packed. Okay, so for each of these, we need two M3 nuts. This is maybe a little confusing. Maybe I'll get the hang of it once I get going. But this isn't... So it says four motor, three... 330s, 310s, 3x30, 3x10s. So I'm guessing M3 times 30mm screws, which we need. And then M3 times 10mm screws, which we don't need yet. And of course, 8 pieces each. And 8 nuts. So let's go with these, I guess. So I'm going to need 4 of the nuts. I two aluminum blocks. Nope, that's a battery pack. For motor, aluminum block. To the 30 millimeter screws. Well, I guess four, because we need. So I'll take this. Shoot, I think I did this backwards. This is supposed to be on the side of the wires. Well, we didn't get too far yet. It's easy enough to fix. Alright, so I'll put these onto the four motors and I'll be right back. So, got all four motors done. So, a couple details that you really need to watch when putting them together. And this is important because if you put them on wrong, then you have the potential of the motors turning the wrong way when you put them onto the chassis. So the first two motors that we did, we wanted the screw holes in the aluminum block facing down. And then in the other two, we wanted them facing up. So that way, when we mount it, we actually have the drive axles all pointing outwards so that we can mount the tires on properly. Then also you want to make sure that the wiring for the motors are on the same side as the aluminum block. That way it all comes in towards the center and it'd be easier to channel the wires back up to the servo controller board. So our next step is to actually mount these onto the chassis. And that's what the 8 10 millimeter M3 screws are for. Or as they're listed on the bag here, 3*10. So we want the 8 screws. So we want the acrylic plate. So the basic shape of these are the same. And they went and leave them both as A. But you want to pay attention to this hole as well as the holes drilled in to the plates. Now, the bottom plate, so the bottom chassis plate, will have these 6 holes on the front because that's where the line following circuitry is going to be attached. Plus, you also want these double holes near the channel holes here, because this is where the motors are going to be mounted. First thing we need to do is move these out of the way. One problem with the laser cut acrylic like this is it can be difficult to remove the paper sometimes. Fortunately, this isn't too bad. Put that underneath so I don't get it all scratched up. They want the motors facing forward. Getting conflicting. Give me a second. Oh, I get it. So all the motors will be facing out. Like this, or more accurately, like this. Alright, I'm going to attach the motors to the plate and I'll be back in a minute. Alright, so I have all four motors screwed in. As you can see, the aluminum blocks are on the inside of each of the motors, and then the actual motor is facing out from each of the four plastic gearboxes. And we have servo wires. What's next? So now is the motor controller board. Oh, here we go. So it's the one with the heat sink, which makes sense because you need the gate bridge in order to drive the servos. Brilliant, guys. You put the notches so it okay. Fortunately. So this is the motor controller board. And you have to pay really close attention which direction this faces. So this is the front of the car, and we want the heat sink facing backwards. So it's going to go on just like this. So this is the L298N. So it looks like they put the fasteners for both this and the Uno in the same bag. There. So I now have all my screws in the one spot. And I'll come back to this. So M3 12 millimeter long screws, and then 8 nuts. And we need 4 of each. Set these up here for when we mount the Uno. That's weird. You'd think there'd be some sort of pad or something under this rather than just screwing it straight down. So of course direction really matters with this thing because these are designated for each of the motors. So you have it the wrong way, then when you intend to drive the two right side motors, you could be accidentally driving the two front motors. So since this is just sitting straight on the solder, I'm not going to completely tighten these nuts right away. I'm just going to fasten it. And then I'll level it off and then tighten it once I have nuts on all four bolts. And of course, you don't want to over tighten this because, again, if it's sitting straight on the solder, you don't want to damage the board, because if you over tighten it, it'll actually bend the corners of the boards in, and that's not good for it. Same time, you don't want it too loose. There we go. And plug each of these in. And they all go in pretty logical. There. have motors. So next we want to put the line followers. What do we call it? Line trackers. So we're going to need hardware for the line trackers. And our three boards. We don't need you yet. You're infrared. The way they did this is actually pretty smart. So here's our three line tracers. And they're each numbered. Then when you look at the instructions, it has them as 1, 2, 3. So they're going to be mounted just like this. Of course, with the connector facing back. So we need, for each one of these, we need two standoffs. Go in like this. And each standoff has a nut put on. Maybe I should do one at a time here. There we go. So because of the little infrared sensors here, it's easier to turn the standoff than it is the nut. There. Then we put it in. Just goes in like this. Then our screws will go here. So I'm going to take care of that, and I'll be right back. So there they are. All three are on. I had to kind of align these a bit, and by doing that, just took my grips, just loosened the nut up slightly, and kind of straightened them out, and then tightened it. But you have to be really careful not to damage the infrared centered and receiver there. Also, I found if you did the back bolt first, like the back screw first, it's a lot easier to line up the front screw when putting it on. So now that's done. Next is to put the Uno on. So this is the top plate of the carriage. And then this is the front, because this is the servo that the ultrasonic sensor mounts to. But right now we are mounting the Uno. Same thing, huh? Yeah, I think my one complaint is, I wish they'd have like some sort of pad that goes between the circuit board and the acrylic. Like it's like a little foam pad or something. Alright, so it looks like... well, I guess it can only go on one way because there's certain screw holes here. Looks like there's only supposed to be three screws here. Like there's four screw holes, but there's only three mounting holes in the plate. That's weird. Whether it's intended that way or not, just don't have a lot of choice. So I wonder what that last screw is for. I always wonder if I should have like background music or something when I do these. Because it might make watching a little easier. I don't know. Put your comments down below and I'll... Also, music type preferences. Keep in mind, I can only really do royalty-free music because I can't afford anything else. So all I'm doing is just putting my finger on the bottom to hold the nut in place while I tighten it. Again, try not to over tighten it because you don't want to warp the board. And then, that's the driver shield. Oh sure, put that on foam. And again, why do they do that? So. Look at that. See, here are the notches, and then the actual ceiling is below the notches. Weird. I wonder if that was just a mistake in packaging. That's why we have. Blades. Pretty sure I know how this goes on. I was just matching up this with the labels on the sides here. There. So next, we want to mount the infrared receiver module. We need this, and we need this. So again, we want to okay, I was wrong. I didn't see that other nut. I was worried that I'd lost it. This kind of project, I wish I had one of those helping hands things so that, goes this way. So I could actually hold this in place so that it's easier to put the parts onto. Driver. Okay, yeah. So the suggestion is put the screw from the bottom, put the standoff on the screw so that the little, and then the threaded pieces from the standoffs point up for the infrared module. Weird. Can't get that to tighten. Oh well. Well, the screw tightened, but I can't get it to stay tight against the plate. That's fine. The other one's tight, so once I put the infrared module on, it should hold it in place. It'll be fine. Alright, so you want the infrared receiver pointing towards the side like this. I'm trying not to do it too much, but at least about a half turn to make it snug. There. So that's just the receiver for the remote control. So you can just
program and do stuff with it. So next is the battery pack.
I was worried because it was like didn't have any end on it, and then I had this. I was worried it got damaged, and then looked at the instructions and realized it's supposed to be like that. So this just pops off. And this is why it's supposed to be like that. So I'm going to leave the cover off because my batteries are still charging. And we want... there, for the cell box. So we want the wires to face the direction of the power input for the Arduino. Actually, easier just do this. Well, we'll do two for now. And then once we kind of get it in place, we'll put the other two in. So one of the things that makes this project interesting is that aside from the laser cut acrylic base and the mounts for the ultrasonic sensors, these are all more or less off the shelf parts. You know, you have a standard Arduino Uno, you have I believe even the line tracers are pretty standard. Your ultrasonic board, I've seen that available like that. I don't know if these boards are custom. Maybe they are, in which case, all right, fine. But, you know, just perf boards are only, are really cheap. You can... you know, just build something with those. Okay, so on your barrel connector, you actually have a plus and minus on the terminals, which, you know, I think might be a little project specific, because what if you're using something where the tip is different? Like, this should actually be labeled what's tip and what's the barrel. So I'm trying to avoid getting the soldering iron out, because this project is, you're supposed to be able to do this project without soldering. If I were to solder those wires together, it would just solve all the problems. But I think we might be alright. See, my worry is, if I put it in and it grabs the insulation, then it won't necessarily make contact with the wires themselves. Alright. The idea is this goes in here like this, and then this goes down to the board down below. Next is hooking up this servo. Maybe. So we want comes with its own screws, so that's something else. Well, sort of. All right, that's for Okay. So I guess we do want this. Alright. This time, though, I am going to be using my tray here because I have some very, very small pieces in here and I really don't want to lose them. Actually, you know, looking at these, I don't think these were laser cut. I think these were milled. Which is pretty neat. Then again, details to the pictures so that you have this pointing the proper direction. Because then when it goes on, you want this facing back. Yeah. So that, because we also have some much smaller ones here too that concerned me. But actually there's four of them, so it's definitely not those. I guess those are probably M1s or something like that. And there we go. So that's the servo attached. And again, when you're putting the screws in, try not to completely tighten it right away. Because that way you can adjust the piece until everything lines up. And that's done. More acrylic. It's neat how they do these angles. Basically what they do is they have this plate that and then there's like hot air that blows up, so it just heats the line, and then they just put it in like a right angle vise to hold it in place. And then once it's cooled, it stays. Alright, so this is the bottom part. Face is down. This is forward. We want so here's the careful of the mesh that you don't push in. I almost did that. Yeah, they are a 1.6. So I'm guessing that means 1.6 millimeter like across, like the diameter of the screw. And you want the connector on the bottom. Goes through like that. Oh, more circuit board up against acrylic. There we go. So managed to get it mounted. Had to do it again though, because the first time I put it on, I actually put this on the wrong side, so. Again, it's a matter of paying attention to detail. Again, we're going to put this in here. We want this one, the one that doesn't have the crosses at the side, like not this one, and certainly not this one. So, so that it's perpendicular. Little screw here. And then this goes on. So we probably want to put these on the outer holes. But you know what? I'm going to use a better screwdriver. Because especially if it's self-tapping, I want something that I have a little more. Started in the acrylic. You know what? And there. Your ultrasonic sensor's on. But I need to fix this again. Here. Take that. Okay. So, it's fastened on there nice and tight. I had to fix my power cord again. Next thing to do. Is to connect this to the, what are you connecting to? Well, this is the servo. Okay, so the brown is ground, red is 5 volts, and then the orange is signal. Go. Easy enough. This next is all the wiring. So these three, because they're longer, they go down to the line trackers. This is the connector to the H bridge and the servo controller. Yet. This is for the infrared, so this guy. So they have little white pins at the top, so they just slide right in. So infrared goes. Fortunately, everything's labeled on the board, so. Oh, that's what it is. So this is for the ultrasonic. This goes into here. So I purposely looped it around because I want to try to manage the cable somewhat. And this actually has a lot of slack, so. And you go into there. And then you... I'm going to rope through here. Three goes into this one. So it's one, two, three. Yeah. Because it's one, two, three. So one, two, three. Three. No. One and three. Oi. Okay. That's all the connectors in place. Next step's an easy one, and of course, once again, the the one notch was actually below, so. Okay, so it actually shows the VCC here, so you put that on the 5 volts. So it goes on like that. There's our Bluetooth module. And we're running out of parts. So next is going to be these guys. I think I would have liked to at least put the standoff on the bottom before we started running all the wires, because it's going to be a little awkward now. So I'll do the first standoff, then I'll come back when it's time to put the top on. Mind you, this is going to be a little easier, because you just hold it in and just screw the standoff on. There, and I'll do the other 5, and I'll be right back. There. So, that was actually a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. So now I'll just put the top piece on. And I'm going to do opposite corners, and then put the middle on last. And there. Finally, put these things on. Try not to force it. And there we go. Complete. Grab the batteries. Well, Duino powered up, that's a good sign. That means it didn't mess up the power connections. And there's a nice on-off switch too, that'll be... Oh, and I have a power light underneath too. So, power works. So there we go. There's the... So there's the robot car put together. I'm a little worried about these motors. They feel a little loose. Might have to go back and tighten it up. And here it is. So, in the next part, we'll upload the programming and we'll try some of the experiments that came with it. Like I know it has the ultrasonic sensor in the front. Has the line trackers, the Bluetooth module, the infrared module for the remote control, but that's the build. So I hope you found that interesting, if not informative, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.